So this is a tool that's been on our review list for over a year now, and it's actually one of the most recommended tools by the community to do a review on, and it's time today to do a Nimbus Note review. Now, Nimbus Note aims to be an Evernote replacement, and that's quite exciting, and we're finally here to check it out. We'll cover the basic features and then place it against Evernote to see what's really different. Today's video is sponsored by Sanebox. Here's a little bit more about that. These days we get inundated with emails, so it seems it's no longer about responding to them all, but the ones that truly matter. And that's why you need to check out Sanebox. I've personally been using Sanebox for the last 2 years and have loved the way that the AI monitors my inbox, moving any unwanted emails right into a folder called Sane Later, leaving me more time to focus on processing emails that are important and not every single one that comes in. Apparently, Sanebox users save roughly 3 to 4 hours a week on email. What's really cool is you can train the system as well, so if you find an email in the wrong folder, just move it and it will train over time. There's no installs, no learning, and it works with all email providers and services out there. I personally use it with Missive. It also has some nifty features like Sane Black Hole, where you can drag messages from annoying senders you never want to hear from again, and Sane Reminders to ping you if someone hasn't replied to your email by a certain date. Now you can get a 2-week free trial and $25 credit by visiting sanebox.com/keepproductive. Anyway folks, a big thank you and I hope you enjoy. So, let's start with some of the general information. Nimbus Note aims to be the place to collect all your information and knowledge, much like tools like Evernote. And for sure, it's positioning themselves as an Evernote replacement, as well as having team abilities and features for collecting knowledge and sharing between departments, hinting at a few coder features in there too. It has been around since 2010, according to their Twitter page, and the team are based in Cleveland, Ohio. So, let's take a look at some of the features. They aim for you to craft wikis, documents, and notes in this tool, and you can also edit notes for your team, sharing internal links with your team and publicly too. You can create tasks, checklists, spreadsheets, and databases, and they do have some capture abilities, which include screenshots, video casts, OCR, as well as E2E encryption and a web clipper too for good measure. It looks much like you would get in an application that we all know, Evernote, and like Evernote, they actually target teams as well. Now there's a lot to unpack here, so let's focus on the main elements and begin with the pricing. Now do remember with this review, we're looking at this from a personal note taker perspective versus the team tools, but we'll talk a little bit about the team tools as well. Okay, let's start with the pricing. Now the starter plan is free and you get with that 100 megabyte upload limit monthly, as well as 50 notes per workspace, and you get 2 workspaces. Now compare that to Evernote and you are getting a better deal with the megabytes per month, but the limitations to taking notes is a huge barrier to entry with only 50 notes per workspace. And of course, Evernote has unlimited notes on the free plan. But do remember, Evernote does have a limit to the 2 devices on the free plan, so they're not perfect. And from places I've looked, Nimbus doesn't have a similar limitation. But in my opinion, a limit to the amount of notes is more painful than device limitations. So on their pro plan, that is priced at $24.99 a year, and it has 5 GB limit monthly to storage, unlimited notes, and 5 workspaces. Now comparing that to Evernote, it's much cheaper, almost $50 a year cheaper, without any discounts at a lower rate of course. But with Evernote, you get twice the amount of storage with 10 GB upload per month. Now Nimbus does offer pricing for team plans with all plans available. And in the pro plan, you can actually add up to 5 team members to collaborate with, which is fairly good, but I'd have to do a full team's perspective feature to explore this further. Now, according to the site, import from Evernote and you get 1 month free, which will save you the monthly fee, which is $4.99. Now Nimbus offers you offline access as part of their starter plan, unlike Evernote, which offers you only desktop offline in the basic free plan and all access offline in their premium plan. So all in all, the pricing's not too bad, but you do suffer if you go with the starter plan, but save in the long term if you go with the pro plan. And I feel like these days people are more comfortable paying for their second brain. Okay, so let's get started a little bit into the design of the application. Now, super similar to design of Evernote and Slack, they haven't really hid this. Side by side, they look pretty similar, but I guess that's the natural look people want for a note-taking software these days. Plus, it does put your mind at rest to knowing where everything is in terms of navigation. Now, Nimbus, like Evernote, works offline on desktop, mobile, and comes on Windows, Mac, iPhone, Android, working on iPad too. Now, we're not security experts, but by the looks of it, Nimbus have a good level of security and actually prioritized it on the navigation bar on their website, which showcases the priority and importance for them. Okay, so before we jump into the note editing side of stuff, let's talk about something that's quite important to many people that use Evernote, at least, the web clipper. So much like Evernote, you can send in notes via email, and using your unique email address, you can send them in and they'll be saved into your Evernote. Now, I tried this inside of Nimbus, and from my last memory of actually using it inside of Evernote, it actually worked better and neater when clipping inside of Nimbus. Now, this is free to use, unlike Evernote, who actually put this inside of their premium plan. And inside of their premium plan, you still have some limitations. With Evernote Premium Business, you can save emails directly into Evernote up to 200 daily using that unique email address. But just a note, inside of the Nimbus account, in order to avoid spam attempts, Nimbus Inbox will accept incoming emails only from the email that is registered to the Nimbus account. So, in terms of the email clipper, I think the email clipper seems to be a little bit better than Evernote, but there are actually two additional clippers. It's complimentary if you have the pro experience. It's quite confusing because you do get these in the starter plan, but you also get them in the pro plan, and there's also two of them, and you can buy the licenses separate. But let's take you through how they work. So the first one is the web clipper, and that's available in the browser. You can get that through Chrome, Opera, and Firefox. And through that web clipper, you can do the regular stuff like clipping articles, clipping details, clipping short pieces of text, and even documents as well. Now, it does work well, but it does look a little bit ugly if you're someone that is coming from the Evernote web clipper, of course. Now, the other tool is a screencast and video recorder, and that's also available through Chrome, Opera, and Firefox. I'll talk about this a little later, but it's actually quite neat, little tool, I guess, if you're looking to sort of share a little idea with somebody that you're working with, a little like you would inside of an app like Loom. But the Pro actually locks specific features in the web clipper, like search text in images, search text in documents, and the document scanner as well. But if I'm honest, it's quite confusing what you get in each plan, so it's worth checking out before you jump in with this application. Okay, so let's break down the core features of this application. The notes editor feels smoother inside of Nimbus. I was using this on web, and much like Evernote's methodology, it's actually well designed. So the notes editor does feel smooth inside of Nimbus. It's much like Evernote's methods of building it. And if I'm honest, the speed of the web tool was actually on par or better than the Evernote edition of the editor, which is pretty impressive, especially from something that is more of a new entry than the likes of Evernote. Now, the editor is easy to use, and you can add all types of media to it, multimedia, naturally. But the thing I'd say is that Evernote do a better job with wrapping everything together. Evernote's ecosystem does feel much more polished, but this could very well be a bias of mine from the years of using the tool. So moving on, the templates are also accessible and help you to save time building specific sets of notes. The only thing I'd say is that Evernote does it better when it comes to note adding. It feels better on mobile and on web because you can quickly access templates, but also find stuff that you've recently produced. So actually, inside of the note editor, Nimbus actually has a few subtle differences, and the main one is the taskbar, which sits on the right-hand side of the screen. This is a really nice feature that I think separates specific tasks instead of you having to crawl through long lists and checking checklists or even having to search. You can extract tasks as you go and add them here. I feel like this is a really neat feature and something Evernote should have probably added years ago. The only way I'd improve this is if it was able to auto-detect maybe checkboxes and sort of put them available inside of that section or something specific so you can don't have to do it manually all the time. Maybe just a note, but something that would improve it even further. I also like how attachments sit on top of the note for better access. Inline, inside of Evernote they appear, but inside of Nimbus they appear at the top of the page, which I think is better and easier to access. But then again, you don't get that inline ability, being able to preview them versus having to open them up separately. So in Nimbus, you can actually modify the appearance, including the text size, style of text, and width. So you can do that inside of Settings. As I said, the clipper is pretty ugly in Nimbus, but it works fast and easily. From the time I used it to clip an article, it was pretty speedy. Another feature that does impress me is the video web clipper. Actually, seems like an impressive feature and a pretty decent extension here. Here's a little bit more about how it works. Say you wanted to demo a website or something like this to somebody, or even talk over it, you can do that and naturally clip it pretty instantaneously. You don't even have to share it necessarily through the platform, but you can definitely do it just directly as well. As a final feature note, I think the mobile edition of the Nimbus application really lets you down. It, in the UK, at least has a shocking 2.7 rating, although that's only 3 ratings. I'm sort of agreeing with that opinion. I crafted a note earlier, and when I was inside the mobile edition, it said that I've created something in the old editor, and apparently I need to use the Mac or Windows version to access that. It just seems a little bit odd. And also the mobile edition seems ported as it's not as snappy as the web and desktop versions, which I was so impressed with, which is a pain. And if you compare it to the likes of Evernote's iOS experience, it does not feel on par at all in terms of the speed and quality, even though the Evernote's one has several issues sometimes. It definitely feels that Nimbus aren't as hot on the mobile versions. Now, fun fact, apparently Nimbus, while I was looking at the mobile version, has a meditation app as well called Nimbus Mind. Very strange. Okay, so I'm going to give you my opinion here. So Tiago Forte recently spoke to me about the Evernote situation and their position on it. And he said that Evernote aren't competing with Notion and Rome anymore. And I believe him in a sense. From Tiago's perspective, they're trying to be the best tool that they've always been, like a note taker and compiling cabinet. And I think Nimbus is trying to fight the same war here. They want to be a robust note taking / file cabinet tool like Evernote, and they do want a piece of the pie. And by the looks of it, it's actually impressing many along the way who are slightly bored of Evernote's development cycle. Whilst they have features like Coda in terms of allowing teams to collaborate, it doesn't really challenge the likes of the Coda model, so they do fall behind there. But when it comes to the face-to-face comparison with Evernote, things aren't too far away. When you're thinking of things like GTD, Evernote does provide more resources and probably comes with more workflow, but in premise they do the same job. Yes, the Evernote web clipper looks better and overall brand of Evernote oozes more stability. I do think Nimbus gives a marvellous effort, and I'd happily say this tool then I'd probably recommend to those who want Evernote on a budget and are comfortable with the experience. And I definitely think if you've been hosting your notes inside of Evernote for a long time, I don't think it's necessarily the jump you necessarily need. But if you're someone brand new looking at a note-taking tool that works like Evernote, this could be a good comparison. Okay, so here's the official score I've given it. So for design, I've given it a 7. For features, I've given it a 6. For pricing, I've given it an 8, although I've noted the fact that obviously they don't have fantastic sort of free plan, but I think their pricing's a lot better than Evernote in the bigger plans. Usability, I've given it a 6 out of 10. And my final opinion, I'd probably give it a 7 out of 10. So whisking that through the math machine, we've given Nimbus Note a 6.8 score, which we think is a good score. If you compare it to IMDb, I think that's more like Step Brothers sort of movie score, a very good comedy, but definitely not a comedy application at that. So folks, I hope you enjoyed today's review. Do check out Nimbus Note below, of course, and we'll give you more details as we know them over time. But if you want some more first impressions, do check out my own personal channel. We're going to be uploading some more reviews here, and I'm excited to have you. So please do subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Cheerio!